fashion magazines are covering this as a huge trend, also known as curtain bangs. We're going to talk about them right now with Michelle Finlayson. If you don't know what a curtain bang is, think of the original Brigitte Bardot.
That's right. So this is inspired by the pop culture icon, Brigitte Bardot, who was a big actress and singer in the 50s and 60s. And she is literally famous for her hair. Yes. Kirsten Dunst, also huge celebrities, Alexa Chung, they're all wearing this very, very big fashion trend for the spring.
So it's not a blunt cut bang.
No.
They're a little bit loose, a little bit messy, a little bit choppy, and they're a little long, right? Like a little playful.
So one of the key features of a curtain bang, of course, is the sweeping or the swooping that comes into this little C shape around the cheekbones, which is really quite cute. It's always shortest in the center of the forehead above the nose, so it could actually sit across the forehead completely or get parted open even on a round face to give that elongation.
Cute.
Yeah, so what's really cool about it is also that it can suit almost any face shape.
Okay.
Even if you have a longer face shape, you just widen the sides, create more of a full fringe out to the sides on a longer face shape, you can still do it. Even Alexa Chung actually has a quite long or longer face shape.
Right.
And so she'll create or just keep that a little bit more full through the center.
Got it. So
you're
going
not necessarily all the time. She's a little, you know, to each their own interpretation for their look that night.
Got it.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't mind me turning Rebecca just to the side, like you've gone way back here to start the fringe. Like it's almost halfway on her head.
It is a full fringe, which means
full.
It starts from that highest point on top of your head, and it's going to give you that really beautiful sweeping action.
That's so pretty.
It looks awesome with you know, a high pony or something very cute for, you know, going out. And it's just, it literally is the biggest trend for spring 2018.
Nice.
So I want to talk about a couple of ways to style it, or if you're thinking about doing this.
Yes.
One of the cool things is that it's really low commitment. I'll show you that this can be swept completely off to the side as if you never really did it.
Okay.
So it can disappear almost. So if you're wanting
good.
To wear it differently one day versus the other. But a couple of things you want to do. We put mousse in here for starters.
Okay.
So to style it, if you take the plunge, ladies, you want to just blow dry it with your fingers first.
Okay.
So when you put mousse into the hair, you're going to put a little bit into the damp hair, blow dry it, just shaking your fingers down and just making sure it has a very nice natural feel. Because imagine, I think you've all been there, where you might have put a round brush right into the fringe, and you have basically 90s tacky instead of 60s chic.
That's right.
So we really want to focus on that natural fall. Then once it's completely dry, that's when you're going to go in with your round brush and give it a slight curve.
Okay.
The other thing I like to do is kind of slightly sweep it off to the sides like this. Turn your head that way. Oh, just let's try the other way. Yep.
Okay.
And it just creates that little bit of that swoop.
Nice.
Next, once you have it all finished, we're going to put a little bit of powder cloud or something that is like a volumizing powder that gives it again that lift and that kind of volume and playfulness.
Yes.
Absorbs any oils.
Right.
Sometimes these can end up to like two individual pieces.
Right.
And that's it. Like stuck to your forehead.
Yes.
And then finish with the hairspray.
Okay.
So
Yeah, no, keep going.
The
Go
last thing I wanted to kind of point out is that it really is low commitment. And I know how many people have tried bangs and hated it.
Yeah.
Right? And been like, oh God, why did I do that? And it reminds them of, you know, when they were four and their mom cut their bangs.
Right.
And they're just so I just wanted to point out that no matter how stylish you want it to look when you're going out, or you know, when you really put the effort into having it like this, there's going to be days where you just don't want to put that effort in.
Right.
And so I just want to point out that because the sides are long, it can easily transition into a beautiful, just cute side fringe.
Right.
So look at how it's just gone.
Yeah. So
and
you've
I
made
love
it into
that.
A sweep, which is beautiful.
I love that.
That's never going to look bad. So a couple of things to know when you are doing this.
Mm-hmm.
Would you advise people to try this at home?
Oh, goodness. There are some YouTube videos out there.
Yeah.
I know that they're there, but I truly would suggest going to a stylist. They'll be able to find the right point at which the hair will fall.
Right.
You know, how full it needs to be on the side of the head so this doesn't look empty.
Right.
And how to create those perfect sweeps. However, you know, hey, you only live once, right?
I do feel like there's a lot that could could go wrong though? Just because it's like you think it's just chopping hair in the front, but really there a lot of thought has gone into where it's starting and how it's going to lay and the sides, you know, having the sides a little bit longer. So
I actually cut her hair this morning.
She had
all layers all one length.
Oh,
and it took me probably 20 to 25 minutes just to cut the fringe because I was paying so much attention to those fine details. So
good
I think it does count.
Absolutely. Okay. Nice modeling, Rebecca. Thank you for that.